Hello, my name is Scott for SBGaming, and welcome to the SBGaming community game of 7 Days to Die. Details in the description below to participate. Night is approaching, so let's get back to it. Although right now, one thing I want to do, we're going to toggle that. Just because, for screenshots, I don't like having something up there in the corner. Gets a little bit annoying. Like, this would be a perfect screenshot, except there's this text sitting there. But, yeah. Not much I can really do about it. Alright, yeah, this is Sector 2. Let's just dig out this nitrate. Actually, I'm going to dig this out. Should eventually break through to the other side right there. Just dig out whatever gravel we can. Oh wow, yeah, there's a lot of gravel here. Set dogs. All right, so we are going to dig up just a bit. And yeah, we might as well drink. And now, 2, 3. All right, at this. Yeah, we're going to lose a little bit of gravel. What's nice about this is it gives you gravel and crushed sand, both which are used, I believe, for concrete. So digging out all this gravel is a good thing. Never let a good resource go to waste. And I think that is... How far down are we right now? We might be near the surface, so... Yeah, about this. Thing going to do... Okay, what is that up there? That looks to be the outside. It is. The outside of what? On this side of the house, I wish you could zoom in a little bit further. Oh, are we on? Okay, I see what where we are at. Yeah, I think there's a bit of gravel here where if we had dug down, we would have dug down into this. Okay, yeah, this is... This looks to be the edge of the pit trap, right here. So we are definitely not going to want to go further than this. Fortunately, they are not going to be able to dig down. They might be able to detect us because of that gap. Now, we're here. 1, 2. All right, about this. Well, I'm going to... It is 11:30, which means no more dogs in a half an hour of in-game time. Yep, this is going to be the end of the digging up. We're not going to go higher than this. To do is dig this out this way. Although with that said, actually I've already lost the stability of that. That could all come down. So one thing I'm going to want to do, it's somewhere right along here, I'm going to want to put some support pillars. Yep, about that. So that will at least hold it up for now. Now, we are going to... Nope. I want right in there. Yep, this needs to be given support. Said, I probably didn't need to build that one specifically. But better safe than sorry. All right, we're going to secure this as well.
Hello.
Hey.
Sorry about that.
No problem. It is day 20 of just after midnight.
Okay.
Let me know when you're in the game. Or did you log in?
I'm not sure if I'm able to join still with that issue that we get.
All right.
So you might have to invite me.
All right, hang on just a moment.
Get Skype working.
I think I've had Skype down at a lower volume level in the past.
Oh, okay. Probably not.
But yeah, I've done a bit more on the base itself. I'm right now in the mine that you probably haven't been down to. It's kind of at the southeast corner of the house.
I'm just waiting to log in and I'll see.
Yep.
Yeah, because I weren't there last weekend either.
Yeah. I think that's when I started building the mine.
Yeah.
But yeah, definitely a lot has changed since you were last here.
So you're going to be going for another...
I'll be going for another
2 hours.
2 hours, yeah.
All right. I'll have to jump off in about an hour, probably.
All right.
I suppose it's better than not coming on at all.
Yeah, if you get some experience. And plus, 4 o'clock rolls around, which would be about 20 minutes. My focus will be going out to... take apart cars and mechanical objects. So it's actually a good thing that you're going to be around.
Okay, that's good. Right, I'm in the game.
Yep.
About to see you.
You just avoided the dog day.
So oh, okay. Just had one of them.
Yep. If you come down, where are you right now?
I was sort of... I was trying to follow your marker, but I think you're underneath me.
Yep. Come down to the bottom level.
Okay.
And apparently
through the hatch.
Yep.
Bottom level of this.
Yep, all the way down.
So, oh, I see.
Right now, this here is going to be the very bottom level of the house. We're not going to dig any further, but we have lots of resources here that we can dig out. And I've started a mine complex in this area, as you can see. So the idea is to have a pillar and then six blocks out and then another pillar. Unfortunately, the pit trap, I've had to put a pillar here just to support the pit trap area above. As you'd see if you go up there, that's where the retaining wall is, essentially. And to prevent that from completely caving in, we need to give it a bit of support. But basically, in this area, you dig out a 8x8 area, make the pillars and posts, and then just dig out everything in the area, and then go up a level or over a level. So right now, we have this sector here. We have this sector over here. This white stuff, kind of rocky white stuff, is nitrate. It's good for gunpowder. It's good for fertilizer and a bunch of other stuff. There's this red stuff that's complete iron, and you get some nice, decent iron from that. So, yep. This is what I've been working on a lot for most of the last session. And, once we go upstairs, you'll see that there's still blocks to upgrade and all that. But, yep. Do you have a good quality pickaxe?
Yep. I'm just going to place down a torch because I can't see. I don't have
a... All right. How many torches are upstairs? Actually, I'm going to have to go upstairs to eat because I'm hungry. I'll lose wellness if I don't.
42%, so I'm okay for a bit. So you just want to mine out the middle of them four pillars?
Yep.
Okay. That's iron pickaxe, okay.
Looks like we might have some visitors.
So next weekend will be a Horde night, right?
Yep.
That'll be fun.
We'll be ending this off around, I think, going into the night of day 20. So we'll have the night of day 20, then the morning, day, and evening of the night.
Yep. So by the time that I get off, it'll probably be around midday, day 20.
Yep, right? Something like that.
Yeah. I'll stay as long as I can, but yeah. Are we doing next week's on a Saturday as normal then, or?
Yes.
Okay. That's fine. I should be fine.
Yeah. This weekend was kind of a bit different. As part of Max Fox's 1,000 subscriber community game, that was interesting. We had about 15 or 16 people in the game. All on Discord.
Oh, that's good.
Yep.
Did you say it was day 70,000 or something?
Yep, we played around with the console commands to advance time to the next Horde days.
I was thinking about, like, I worked out based on the 60 time scale. I was like, 8 years.
It was basically supposed to be a 7 to 12 hour or 7 to 10 hour stream. The first four hours worked fine, and then there was a power outage over at their side where they were hosting the server.
Oh, okay.
And then what ended up happening is the save file got corrupted, and some of our some of us who had jumped in afterwards immediately had got their character reset to zero. And some were trying to log in, jumping, and they were falling through the world, and so we decided to start over, basically.
Yeah.
But we started at day 8 and kept on going from there. We got to the day 14 horde as normal, but it was getting late, so like, let's just jump over to the next horde night. So we jumped over to horde night 21 and just did back-to-back horde nights.
Oh, wow, that sounds good.
Yep. And then let's do day 70 because every week the difficulty is supposed to ramp up. And that was easy. And then we started consoling in a whole bunch of just random weapons, like rocket launchers and all that stuff. And so everyone had like rocket launchers with like, say, 1,000 rockets. We ramped up the day to day 70 or 7,000.
Wow.
We turned on the zombies were always, originally they were always walking, so even at night, yeah. But then we switched it so that zombies also always run, and then we advanced time to day 70,000.
Was it like significantly harder at day 70,000?
Not really. Of course, with the weaponry we had, and especially with turning the zombies on, that started to lag things like crazy. Like,
yeah, I can imagine.
We have dogs upstairs.
I could hear that. I was thinking, what's that?
It's not day. It's
so above us, is this the pit track that we've got?
Below us is the trench.
Oh, it's below us.
Yep. The edge of the house is right here where I'm standing. And so we have a pit trap out. Wow. I don't think dogs are supposed to normally spawn other than on dog days or if a screamer calls them. Well, I'm undetected, so... They know we're here, but they don't know we're here.
So are we digging this down, or?
Basically digging as far down. I'm going to want to be careful. When you dig out the gravel, you'll get stone as well as crushed sand, which is very good for concrete, which I want to upgrade to eventually. But one thing we'll need is a concrete mixer, which requires an engine, we need mechanical parts, which we need to take apart different objects in order to get them. But this mine looks very extensive. The gravel leads to iron in the various ores, so...
Am I doing this right? I'm getting some nitrate powder from this?
Yep.
Okay.
Alright.
Oh, this shovel needs repairing.
Thank you. Yeah, this is going way down. Which is good for us. Alright. How far down does that go? So we have 1, 2, 3. That will be a floor. Should have support. /242. A little over 1 more hour until daytime. Yeah, haven't gotten very far from the base just because dogs.
Had a lot of them dog nights then.
Oh yeah, like in the last session, right around midnight when it switched to day 19, the dogs showed up, and then they showed up once again at about 9 a.m. I'm like, wow. And then, of course, they're showing up now, although with that said, it was day 20, so there's no reason for them to actually show up. Because they're not scheduled to show up.
How often are they meant to?
On day 12 and every 7 days after that, supposed to be. So day 12, right. Day 19, day 26. But then after day 28, it kind of gets messed up, so it comes... a day before Horde Night rather than 2 days.
Oh, okay. So is this the plan, just to dig it out and then place down these 4x4 grids?
Yep.
When we get to it? Alright. Getting stuck, it's best to have to escape out of it. How do I get one of them headlights that you've got then?
We're going to need to find you a mining helmet.
Ah, okay. I wondered if you could craft them.
If you manage to find a football helmet, if you go into the crafting screen and type in mining, you'll see that it requires a football helmet, a flashlight, electrical perks, duct tape, and scrap plastics.
Yeah.
Plus, the icon next to mining helmet says workbench, which is something I'm working towards.
Okay.
I have the skill to get the to make a mic workbench, but we need the mechanical parts in order to be able to actually make one.
Yeah. I think the thing that we got from that Hard Knight one stuff were in that chest, I believe.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah, we got lots of iron here, which is going to be good.
I'll put the torch down now, okay.
One thing I'd like them to add into this game is an offhand slot, so you could, for instance, hold a torch in one hand and a pickaxe in the other hand.
Yeah, that would be a good idea. That's something that they added to Minecraft not long ago.
Yeah, because right now you can either have a torch or you can have a weapon or a tool.
Yeah. Although funnily enough, in Minecraft, when you hold a torch, it doesn't actually give out light.
Really?
Yeah, so if you were to put, like, I often still put the torch in the offhand if I'm ever playing it. It's still been months since I played it, but when I used to play, I used to put the torch in the offhand and then the pickaxe in the other hand, so when I could see it diminishing.
Yep.
I could just quickly place another torch down without having to swap back to the inventory. Because they're pretty inexpensive, really, when you get going.
Yep.
So you just place one down as soon as it gets dark and on your way. But it would be a good idea if they did add the ability for torches to give out light.
Yep.
They've got the issue with that, with it being affecting the AI and stuff based on the light conditions.
Okay.
Like the only way that anything that's like a mob that's going to try and hurt you can spawn in is if it's actually dark enough.
Wow.
So, yeah.
So
like,
the torch in Minecraft doesn't actually give off any light? That doesn't make it easier to see, or...?
Oh, it makes it easier to see if you place it down. But if it's in your hand, then it does nothing.
All right, admit that. I guess it's not lit if you're not holding it.
Well, yeah.
Or if you're holding it.
The icon of it shows that it's lit at the end.
Wow.
But it doesn't actually give out any light. But obviously, it's pixelated, so like that's the item anyway. It just got this small glow at the end. But when you place it, it's got a flame effect as well. So I guess it's not lit until you place it.
Yep.
But I can see why they haven't been able to add the ability to place it down, to have it lit when it's in your hand.
Yep.
Because the amount of calculations that they have to do on all of the mobs in the game, for if they're able to spawn near the player because of the light or something. It's interesting, but yeah,
yep.
they should have really, in the future, made that a thing. Because it makes sense if you're holding the torch that it would give off light.
Yeah, it should.
I guess it's one of the many quirks of that game.
Yeah, I've never played it myself.
It isn't a bad game, but I suppose the nature of it, with like the nature of what it is, you get a lot of kids playing it as well.
For me, it's more the graphics.
Because yeah.
I grew up on like the 8-bit NES, and at the time that was, the graphics of the time. They were limited to, that kind of graphics. So when I see a game coming out, it came out, 2009, 2010-ish?
Yeah.
Because I remember some of the kids in the drum corps I taught were playing it. And, I'm like, really? It's the 2000s, and you're using pixel graphics. Thank you for joining me for this episode of the SB Gaming Community Game of 7 Days to Die. Details in the description below to participate. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming, and as always, have a good day.